ridiculed her and they rejected him. He said he was amazed at their lack of faith, and so he left them without healing people. There's some just few persons he had to kill. This is another place where he says that Jesus was amazed. And then the Lord stops and then expressed his surprise and said, I have never seen such a faith, even in Israel. And then he issued the word and he healed the man's servant's sickness. And then, friends, tell you something. Just before I go further, something I just read out this one for you. Something that makes this man very unique. He cared for his servants. He was concerned. He had compassion to, and so he had regard for his slave. Why is it so unique? Because before now, they considered slaves as nobody. This is what Aristotle, the great Greek philosopher, said. He said that there could be no friendship and no justice towards inanimate things, objects, not even towards a horse, an ox, or a slave. So you can imagine a slave is being compared to an animal. He's being compared to a horse, to a goat. A slave is a human being like you and I, has flesh and blood, has the spirit of God running in him or her. A slave, because master and slave, we are considered to have nothing in common. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And then he went further to say, a slave, he said, is a living tool. You know what is a tool? Implement you use to walk, so it's of no use after the walk. And even in the process of the walk, you can destroy that tool. A living tool, just as a tool, is an inanimate slave. So a slave was looked at as nobody. That was the man he showed favor to. Then another Greek Roman law expert called Gaius. This is what he said about slaves. That it was universally accepted that the master possessed the power of life and death over his slave. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Then another Roman writer in the person of Pharaoh said this, that the only difference between a slave, a beast, and a cat was that the slave thought. Praise the Lord. The difference between a slave, a beast, and a cat. You know what cat is? Not physical though. Cats, in the olden days, there are these things that they use in carrying goods. They will put it on the donkey. That means that as the donkey moves, it will be moving, carrying loot on it. If you like, I call it wheelbarrow. I don't know the wheelbarrow, the big wheelbarrow, you put it on a donkey or a horse, and then it will be dragging the cat. That's why they say you don't put the cat before the what? The horse. So that cat was just used for, he said, a slave was being compared to this, was compared to a horse, was compared to just something that was being used. That the only difference is that a slave can do what? Or if you slap him, say, but why are you slapping me? You can imagine the level that this man was brought to. This is the message that this man showed so much concern about. How was the person he was so concerned about that he had to send for Jesus? And that prompted the reaction of Jesus. And then secondly, he also sent words when Jesus was coming to his house to say, Lord, come, so that you don't get contaminated by stepping into my house. Secondly, for him to have said that, he had faith in Jesus. Amen. And then also for him to say that, he demonstrated humility, irrespective of his position in society. was humble to say to Jesus, look, I am unworthy. The people who went to him that sit on his behalf outlined his own heart, but he never looked at that. Jesus responded to the man's request, not because of those things that we have mentioned. Sometimes many of us have had to stand in prayer and say, God, I have gone to church every Sunday. I keep all the laws and the commandments. I do not commit sin. I do not do this. I do not do that. I am a good job. I do that. I do that. My brother, no. That's not what God. That's not what they expect to help you. Nobody, because the word of God says in the book of Romans, it says, we all have sinned and fallen short of what? The glory of what? God. Our righteousness is the righteousness of Jesus. The only person who merits whatever that we gain in life is but Jesus. That's why it says, at the mention of the name of Jesus, every name was what? Power. And then this centurion, he came to understand the workings of authority. That's why he said, speak it and it shall work well with me. Amen. I pray that the Lord will speak that word for somebody this morning in the name of Jesus. And it shall happen for you. And your faith as assured. I know that many of us are here this morning. If I may ask, I think this. Why did you come here this morning? And I may not pay favor. And if I don't pay favor, praise and rot. Because you are righteous and qualified, I mean. Who will be? Praise God for the good things He has done for your life, for the gift of life that He has given to you. Very good. Amen. And this shall be so for you in Jesus' name. The best, one of the best answers is you came here because of your faith in God. Chicken. Who will faith in God?
Treat them.
else under you. How do you treat them?
He says, the man loved his slave,
not even servant, slave. His servant was compared to a dog.
He loved him so much. He loved him so much that he did not want him to die.
Have you ever wished somebody dead? Granted, you're paying your servants or those working for you, so they should eat from that. If they eat from the 15,000 naira you pay at the end of the month, well, how much is spent for him or her? You cannot spend 200 naira for him to buy food in the afternoon when he's working in the shop for you. He carries loads. Sometimes he carries something, something will hit him and he will get injured. Do you show concern? When he comes out the next day, you compel him to do every amount of job without feeling the pain that he or she is going through. She must do everything. The African man believes that why should he go to the kitchen and cook? I said, what if he's got to go to the kitchen before? Say no. That would be. Where am I? She's not there. She did. Did I ever go back in that kitchen cook before? You cook when she's not around. Sometimes when she's around, tell her to sit down and prepare the food. They said they cannot do it. You can. Sometimes they come back tired. But you've been in the house, you need paper. Get to the kitchen, boil water for the woman. He doesn't stop anything. Boil water, bring water, put it in a basin, put salt, massage the leg for her. She will be strengthened.
Okay.
Amen.
When they go to the supermarket, the man will walk in first, he will open the door, and the woman will. They say, ladies first. Ladies walk first. But here, when they bring the food, they will start calling down. Bring water, give you, you will wash it. Then you start to eat before they will dish their own food. No. That is love and care. So some of our men change. We need to move, upgrade. Every time woman. Because sometimes you give 10,000 naira for the week. She's the one who goes to the market. Prices of things have changed. And when she comes back and says, you need to scream. But that's the truth. Prices have changed. That money is not enough again because of the number of persons in the family. When I was growing up, my mother taught us how to cook. I used to cook. Because my mother had years late, so we are men more. Then later on, as a seminarian and then a priest, somehow, because of work, I lost how to cook. Yes. I forgot the ones I used to know. But then, about 4 years back, I got it back again. And that's why. The time Bishop sent me to my village, it was not all negative. There were new things I learned. Because then, I was living two lives, village and Port Harcourt, go to school in Unicourt, come back, go. So I was living alone. I used to go to market. Sometimes when I walk into the market, if I come back from Unicourt, I drive into market of East West School and I stop. Some cafes would say, I said, Father, say good afternoon, good evening, I get to buy something. I don't have to buy fish. In fact, I was never making soup that time. I know how I enjoyed it, but I didn't know how to cook. I learned it that time. The big kind of soup, or half of soup. I had to use water leaf and all that to cook it. I reactivated that. So sometimes if my cookmate guy, after the washings, I'm in the kitchen. It doesn't take anything from you. It makes the work lesser for the women. I don't know what my spirit is leading me to talk about that this month. But as part of love and care, we can show. And that sometimes not do like you are the man. There could be a time that the woman is not there. How can they kill you? Because for that, no day. For what now? Or you begin to run out and then you get to the kitchen. Because you already know the dictates. Or no sabidu was so that you say that she did not know how to cook well again. So but what are we talking about? Love and what? Care. Show care to your husband. Show care to your wife. Show concern. That way you see that you are living out what you profess and things. The children and the people staying around you. Show them love and care. Some of our apprentices steal our money because they are tight fisted, like a gun. They are working out the money for you, but you cannot spend 200 naira or 500 naira to feed them daily. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When you show them that love and care, they will not steal your money. They will not take away able to defraud you. I know that everybody is not perfect, but many will behave well. I'll tell you a story. My first year as a priest, the parish where I was working, I had a secretary, and then it was in the rural area. When I came in, she was being paid small amounts of money. And then when people bring their tithes from the various parishes, she collects and she records and calculates. And at the end of the month, the money was making like 100 and something, those things, all about 2002. That was big money. Or sometimes at the end, we have about 300 to 500,000 naira. And she was being paid, I can't remember, either 6,000 or 10,000. And I looked at it, you're putting this young woman to temptation. She records, she collects and keeps the records. She was very honest. So what did I do? I had to increase her salary so that she would not be tempted to steal. That way they give you better reports. You don't even care. That's what that man did. He cared for his boy, his life. Dad of God, I proclaim that for you this morning in the name of Jesus. That your business that is located somewhere, that by the fact of your faith expression in Jesus, with this covenant of every morning, Monday morning, that the Lord will speak a word, that the word that we speak, that we proclaim, that we teach, we have the faith upon your life in the name of Jesus. My dear friends, there are so many people who have such experiences. Our God is a God who walketh in as your distance, from a distance. It doesn't matter the location. That's why we put mass. For somebody in America, God has it. Like you pray for somebody somewhere, God has it. But because that faith expression is what God wants. Your faith expression in God is what He wants. And that will be the source of healing for you and for someone. Look at the Syrophoenician woman who came to Jesus. I said, my daughter is sick. Jesus said, ah, it's a agenda. Don't bother me. And the Lord said to her, and she insisted. Jesus said, we'll give the food to the, can't give the children's food to the dog. He said, yes, even the dogs food from what? Under the table. And the Lord said, oh, your daughter will not die. She will live. Child of God, I proclaim that to you this morning. That situation will not die, will not cause death for you in the name of Jesus. That your business will be resuscitated in the name of Jesus. That your marriage will be resuscitated in the name of Jesus. And the fact and expression of your faith this morning in Christ Jesus our Lord. And she walked back. And when she got there, the child was healed. Is it the official who came to Jesus? And Jesus said to him, go, your son will not heal, will not die. And by the time he arrived home the next day, the child was busy running up and down, and he asked him, what point, at what time, the two he said exactly, that was when the Lord said, go, he will not die, and he did not die. Faith in action. And so there is a correspondence between what we express and what we encounter when the Lord speaks. That you step in here every Monday, you think you're wasting your time. You think you're wasting time? You think that we'll come here for a joke every Monday morning? No, we are not coming for a joke. God sees that your faith, that your innocent faith. You might not be worthy, but in His own good way, He will send out His word and He will heal that circumstance for you. In the name of Jesus. If there's nothing you don't believe about, don't believe in a God who worketh from a distance. In 2 Kings chapter 5, from verse 1 through 15 to 16, you meet someone who was diseased, Naaman the leper. Naaman was told, and so the king of Aram sent him to the king of Israel. And when the king of Israel saw the letter, he said, this man wants to start war with me. Why would he send a man that had leprosy to me? What business do I have to do with that? And then when the prophet Elisha saw it and heard Catholic Church. That there is a God in the Immaculate Hearts. Who you see his face every Monday and every Friday, and you think his eyes are blind. They are not blind. They see. And the prophet, he sent Naaman to the prophet. And then when Naaman approached the house of the prophet Elisha, on arrival to the entrance of the house, Elisha sent his servants to him, to speak to him. Elisha did not come out to touch him. Elisha did not see him eye to eye. Elisha only sent words to him and said, go to the Jordan and pass seven times, and you will be well. The man got angry. Why could he even say like that? First of all, he looked at himself. Me, a commander of army, coming, and this man refused to come to see me. What nonsense! He decided to go back home. And his servant said, but sorry, hold it there. Supposing he had told you to do something more than that, couldn't you have got it? Just go to the Jordan. Dip yourself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you are one fresh again. And the man said, oh, I think it's true. Then friends in life, you need intermediaries. You need intercessors. You need mediators. They said, children have a need and mediators whom he sent to Jesus. Elisha had a mediator whom he sent to Naaman. Naaman had intercessors and mediators who said to him, you don't need to grow angry. Be humble, believe and trust, and you shall come to pass. Because the mediator and intercessor on his behalf, he obeyed, and that obedience brought his healing. Child of God, because there is a mediator between us and God, Jesus, God will grant your heart desire. God will hear your prayer. You are not here on anybody's ground. You are here on God's ground. You are here because of Jesus. What the book of Hebrews says, he is our mediator, our perfect high priest, Jesus Christ, who mediates God's favor, God's healing to us. By your faith, may you connect to that healing mansion of Jesus in the name of Jesus. And the man went to the river of water, and then eventually what happened? He came out fresh skin. Everybody say fresh skin.
Fresh skin.
I pray for a fresh skin for you.
Yeah.
I pray for fresh opportunity for you.
Yeah.
This week will open fresh opportunities for you in the name of Jesus. The opportunities that have been leprous in your life, that are cancerous, shall be healed by the divine healing authority of the word of God for you in the name of Jesus. You will not come back with leprosy. Business leprosy will go. Financial leprosy will go. Health leprosy will go. And you will have healing. Family leprosy will leave you. You shall be well again in the name of Jesus. But when the Lord sends us his word, he says, the people have problems and they approach God. When they approach God, the psalmist says in Psalm 107, verse 20, he sent down his word and he healed them. He touched me. He touched me. And I know. Of God in your life. You will not die of that condition. Your child will not die on that condition. Your family will not die on that condition. See, in that world, Luke's Gospel, chapter 7, from verse 1 to 10, he said that the man was sick and was dying, but not that he died. In fact, in the word, in the Greek word of that text, Luke presents it that he was a bad case. Because Luke was a physician, so he gave him a medical diagnosis and said the man was in a very bad case. Might you say he was paralyzed and the fact was finished? But when Jesus sent him, what happened? Bad case became what? A good case. Your bad case, whether that case is in the court and people are standing against you, that case will turn out in your favor in the name of Jesus. I connect that court room where your matter is to be decided with the word of God spoken by Jesus this morning that says, go, your son will not die. You will not be locked out of your favor in that court room in the name of Jesus. Wherever the judge might be, and whoever the judge might be, the Spirit of God will arrest that person in the name of Jesus. Because it is only a person who has faith that will say, speak the word, and my servant will be what? Can I hear you say that, Lord, speak the word, and I shall be healed? Again. Say it several times.
And faith in God, and say to the Lord, God, morning that you confirm my faith in your words that I apply it in my life, that the promises you have given in your words will impact my life for a positive change, for a healing, for deliverance, and for your favor in the name of Jesus.
It's not a time to run around to people. It's a time for you to stand and make a declaration.
God will lead.
I give you assignment. Where you go today, while you are sitting in your shop or in your office, make up time. Read Genesis 1 to verse 16 or 20, something of it. Chapter 1 of it. He said, and God said, and God said, let there be light. And God said, let there be fish. And there was one fish. Let there be water. And there was one water. So that the water of life will flow into your own life in the name of Jesus. If there is any negative thing somebody has spoken about you and against you, by your own power and authority and your faith in Christ Jesus, you will be fighting with the unspoken one in the name of Jesus. As you get to your shop or your office this morning, stand your ground. Make a declaration and say, God, today I take authority over my shop. I don't care what my negative thing anybody has spoken, but what I speak unto my shop this week is that I will serve, is that favor will follow me this week. I will come out and go back home happy. I will not just go and come back. I shall be fruitful this week in the name of Jesus. Make that declaration and heaven will honor your words. Show that confidence in God. Show the confidence in God. In Luke's Gospel, in chapter 1 and chapter 2 or thereabouts, God sent an angel to Mary and spoke to her. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. And she said, how can you be guilty of this? I'm just a mother. He said, yes, you find favor with God. Child of God, you have found favor with God. Because of your faith, you have found favor. Not because you are qualified, but the favor of grace has located you. He said to her, you've been chosen by God to be the mother of God. He said, how can that be possible since I'm a virgin? He said, the power of the Holy Spirit will overshadow you. And the child to be born will be called holy. You need to take off.
in Acts chapter 10, the centurion, because of his good work and his good life, God positioned the helper for him. God positioned Peter to come to his house to bring deliverance of favor upon his household and preach the word of God to them. As you go out this morning, tell the Lord that he should, that let your hand that has never received favor receive favor. Let God position people who will help you. Let God position people who will intercede for you. Let God see your faith in him and your trust in him and come to your aid in the name of Jesus. Every threatening situation upon your life this week, may that threatening situation be submerged in the favor of God in your life in the name of Jesus. That threatening situation will receive healing in the name of Jesus.